Hello and welcome. This video provides an example of a phishing email that appears to come from Microsoft Voicenote. Let's take a look at the email to highlight some of the issues. The first indication that this email isn't genuine is the sender's information. While at first glance it appears to come from Microsoft Voicenote, the sender's domain, which is the part of the email address after the @ sign, does not contain Microsoft.com, which is the Microsoft domain. This is a red flag that should warn you this might be a scam. If you are in doubt, always check the domain first. In this case, an internet search also reveals that Microsoft Voicenote is not even a genuine Microsoft application. While there is an application in the Microsoft Store called Voicenote, it is created by Samsung, not Microsoft. You can also research the applications used at UCR by searching the UCR knowledge base. In this instance, a search for Voicenote will reveal that UCR uses Cisco Jabber for voice messaging. If you receive a message to your work email, you should always consider whether or not it is something you would expect to receive at work. If you are in doubt and the message either mentions or appears to come from an individual, you can check if they have an affiliation with UCR. A quick search of the UCR profiles page will show that in this case the sender is not associated with UCR. Even if a name does produce a match, it is possible that the person is being impersonated, so you should still look carefully at any emails you receive. Further inspection of the email will reveal that there are additional red flags. The Voicenote sender's phone number is not in the standard format for the US. The email looks like it contains a playable audio file that you can listen to by clicking on the embedded player. However, hovering over the player reveals it points to a web address. This tells us that the player is actually just an image that is designed to get you to inadvertently open a link. Hovering over the other links in the email reveals similar web addresses. This type of scrutiny allows you to view where the links in any email point without actually clicking on them. Doing this allows you to compare them with the sender's known websites. To find this information, you can do a quick internet search. In this instance, a search for Microsoft reveals the official domain for Microsoft differs from the domain in the message. Further examination of the links in the message highlights another issue. They both use an HTTP rather than an HTTPS prefix. This is a small but important distinction. The S in HTTPS means secure, and indicates that the website uses encryption for sending and receiving data. This designation also requires the website owner has verified that they are who they claim to be. When browsing the web, you should always look for the S and a lock in your browser's navigation bar. While this by itself doesn't necessarily mean the site is safe, it does indicate that data transmission is encrypted. A site claiming to represent a major brand like Microsoft that is lacking an HTTPS prefix should definitely be viewed with suspicion. Voice messages are a common format for phishing scams, known as vishing. You can stay up to date on vishing and other scams by searching on the internet. The FBI provides information on different types of phishing scams, as well as information on protecting yourself. Staying educated is important. 82% of data breaches in 2021 involved a human element. This confirms that the actions people take play a major role in security incidents. Technology designed to block phishing attacks such as spam filters and antivirus software are effective and will block a substantial number of threats. However, some threats will bypass those defenses and will reach employees. Without training or education, on average, over 32% of employees interact with simulated phishing emails. Remember, you should carefully examine any unsolicited or suspicious communications and report anything that doesn't look right. When you receive emails, you should always make sure you stop and think before you connect. For additional information, please visit our CyberSmart page. Thank you for watching.